Victory is supported by Skyline Drive Corvette Club and Chandler Lodge 227 of the Free and Accepted Order of Masons.
Greetings, welcome to Victory, here on BCTV, your channel to your community. Hi, I'm Tom Frank, your Victory host. Tonight's topic is a Lions Club. In particular, the West Reading Wyomissing Lions Club is in Studio A. And we're going to be talking to some of their officers, some of their activities that they'll be doing throughout the year, what they've done last year, which is a key part, because that was one of their chartered years, just last year. But before we go any further with this information of this great topic, let's meet our guests tonight on the panel.
My name is Charlie Wenrick, and I'm the treasurer of the West Reading Wyomissing Lions Club.
Welcome.
Good evening. My name is Past District Governor Carl Gundrum. I'm with the Elverson Morgantown Lions Club, and I'm also the guiding lion for the West Reading Wyomissing Lions.
Very good.
And my name is Dave Bednes. I am the current president of the West Reading Wyomissing Lions Club.
Welcome all for coming out tonight. Lions is international. It's truly all over the world. And it's amazing in the number of size that they are. Men and women together come together in this organization to do nothing but good for the community. Everything that is raised, fundraiser-wise, is all put back into the local communities from where these fundraisers are held from. We're going to be talking about some upcoming events, but more importantly, let's learn a little bit more about Lions, what they're all truly about. We have some video segments, some DVDs that we're going to show you. In the first segment, we're going to show you a public announcement address about Lions International. So let's run that, if we could, at this time for you to get a better feel of what Lions International truly is all about.
Diabetics, anyone over 60.
African Americans and Hispanics over 40.
We're all at risk for vision loss. Eye diseases can sneak up without symptoms.
But these diseases can be treated.
And vision loss prevented if they're caught in time. If you're in one of these risk groups,
or have a family history of eye disease,
please have a dilated eye exam once a year. Don't lose sight of eye disease. How far would you go to keep your vision? Anyone with diabetes is at risk for vision loss.
Diabetic eye diseases can sneak up without symptoms.
But these diseases can be treated.
And vision loss prevented
if they're caught with early screening.
If you have diabetes,
have a dilated eye exam once a year. It's an hour of your time and worth it. How far would you go to keep your vision?
Lions live where you do. Lions care about the things you do. Every Lions Club, a reflection of the community we serve. Lions make a difference, meeting the needs of people and communities, every day, everywhere. In China, Lions Club's International Foundation, LCIF, launched a groundbreaking program to combat blindness.
The World Health Organization formally announced that the Sight First China Action would be a model for developing countries in preventing and curing blindness.
In 5 years, Lions restored sight to 2.1 million Chinese.
I feel very excited. Many thanks for doing the cataract extraction operation on me and enabling me to see the light.
Lions Sight First has saved and restored vision to millions of people worldwide. Lions champion the needs of people and help fill the voids that exist in communities around the world. Lions make a difference. Every day, everywhere.
In times of need, we're there. Developing communities, supporting young people, giving sight. We're there. Help us help others. Make a real difference.
Independence. Freedom. Lions helped to make this possible for me. Join today. Serve. LionsClubs.org.
We're there!
Did you know volunteering can be fun? Community service is for everyone. Young people, families, men, women. As a volunteer, you'll help your community and gain valuable skills. Network with others. Energize your life. Make an impact and have fun. Get in step with your community. Volunteer. Visit www.lionsclubs.org.
Just tuned in, you're watching BCTV, your channel to your community. This is the Victory Show, and we're highlighting Lions International, in particularly one of our many Lions clubs here within Berks County. Tonight we have the West Reading and Wyomissing Lions Club. As you just saw the video segment, it's just basically describing to you what the mission statement truly is all about by Lions International. Let's meet some of our, again, our local topics about the eye care program, which is one of the key essentials part. If we could go to Lion Brother Carl, tell us about the number of glasses that are basically collected each year that are distributed to people in need.
Every year, Pennsylvania alone collects over 1.5 million pair of used eyeglasses. And these eyeglasses are then sent to distributing centers that are run by Lions members, and ours is in New Jersey. And there they are cleaned and fitted for their prescription. And they're packed up, and twice a year, Lions will go to third world countries to distribute these glasses. And a lot of times, the villagers or the people, when they learn of the Lions coming there, they will sometimes walk 2-3 days and then wait another 2-3 days just in hopes that those men and women in the gold vests will fit them with a pair of glasses so that they can see for the first time in their lives. It's really an amazing thing that the Lions do, but that's just one of the many things as far as eye care that we help with.
It truly is. It's unbelievable. And Charlie, within the West Reading Wyomissing Chapter Club, where are the boxes located within the community?
We have three boxes located in the community. One at West Reading Borough Hall, one in the Customers Bank branch in the 500 block of Penn Avenue, and one in my office, Wenrick Insurance, in the 400 block of Penn Avenue. Any time that those businesses are open, stop in and drop glasses in the box.
That's just amazing. I know some were delivered tonight here at the studio. That can be, you know, taken on to the forward process of processing them through. So eye care is essential, but the Lions Club has taken that torch and have held it very high in doing it each and every year. Now, good news story about we always like to talk about here within our Berks County, and this current sitting president and been sitting president in your second year, Dave. Tell us about how the West Reading Wyomissing Club all kind of came back together and rechaptered itself. And we're going to talk about the Guiding Lion as too, one of which is with us tonight.
Well, we kind of luck of the draw that a need was for a club was in West Reading Wyomissing. And some local people, Carl being one of them, took it upon themselves to bring a club back to us. And we kind of have 13 members active now, half a dozen on a continuous basis. They get together and try to do some good stuff in the community.
When are the meetings held mostly with the West Reading Wyomissing Club?
We are the first Thursdays at 8 a.m. in the morning at the Wyomissing Family Restaurant.
Okay.
And third Thursdays at noon at the Chef Allen's restaurant.
Nice. So it's always great to tie food with it.
Yes.
If you feed them, they will come.
That's what we hope.
That's true.
Now, there is a meeting coming in December, I believe, which will be an evening meeting.
Correct.
Tell us about that.
Once a quarter right now, we meet in evenings, which is more typical for Lions clubs, but because of our younger member base, it's a little more difficult for some of our people to meet in the evening. So once a quarter,
sure.
We meet at 6:30. To accommodate other people and hopefully get other people to come in and join the club.
Excellent. Now, there's many clubs within Berks County, but let's go back, if we could, to Carl, who's, by the way, past district governor of P14P. Could you tell us about how Pennsylvania is structured? Our club falls within the district of 14P.
That's correct.
Now, as a past district governor, how many groups are there within Pennsylvania that are districts?
Well, the history of it goes that in 1920, 3 years after Lions was formed, there was a club formed in Pittsburgh. And from there, it traveled east until it started in Philadelphia then and traveled from there west. And the whole state of Pennsylvania became one giant district, which is number 14. And within those, within that state, we have 18 different districts.
Okay.
And we have 18 sitting district governors each year who, it's their responsibilities to go around and promote Lions International and the International President's program and goals for the year. And I believe this year's our International President has a tree planting. He's very environmental minded, and this year he has a tree planting program. And his goal was to plant 1 million trees, 1.3 actually, because that's how many, one tree for each member. And so far in 6 short months, we've tripled that to about 3.8 million trees. So it's a very worthwhile project. And I know the West Reading Lions are involved with that this year also, and they have a tree planting situation coming up. And that will be in April?
March or April.
March or April. Mm-hmm. But those are the type of things we do, not only for blind, but anything.
Absolutely. It's all about Earth Day, as President Dave just alluded to. March-April time frame. Tell us about last Earth Day, of the members that came out, what tasks they accomplished, and what's set forward for this coming spring in 2012.
We're very privileged to be in the West Reading community, where Earth Day has been a very big activity mm-hmm. for them in the past. So we were able to contribute this year by cleaning up along the bypass and under the bridges. Trash. Charlie, I don't know if you remember how many bags we had, but it was
truckloads. As I recall, I think there were 18 bags of trash picked up in a two or three hour period.
Very many. And then this year we're going to segue that into planting trees in the area. I believe we're going to try to do Blue Marsh and do at least 100 trees in the community. So.
Wow. Now, other functions too that this local club does is tell us about the holidays on Penn Avenue. That's coming up also in December.
Correct. Anything going on in West Reading, we try to get involved in. Art on the Avenue in June, upcoming in December is the Holiday Glow festivities, which is kicked off on December 2nd with the Tree Lighting Festival at 6 p.m. After that, people are encouraged to come on the Avenue and see what's going on, at which time we'll be out there. Mingling a little bit and doing what exactly, I'm not sure, but we'll have something to kind of get our club's name out there.
Mm-hmm. Now, if anybody has any questions throughout tonight's program that they're viewing and would like to get in contact with the Lions, I know you wrote it down on the program sheet, but tell us what it is verbally, and then tonight, as we come off the show tonight, as we exit out, we'll put it up for the home viewers.
Sure. Our local email address is wrwlions@gmail.com. You can go to that, email us any questions you have. If you're interested in getting involved, we'll get back to you and tell you what you can do and how to come out and meet us.
Right. And Carl, the lionsclub.org, is that the international site?
Yes. Lionsclubs.org is international. And if there's anyone who is interested in becoming a Lion or knowing more about Lions or would like to find a club near them, they can go to that website and in the search engine just look up a city or zip code.
Fabulous.
And they can easily find a locus, the local Lions Club that they can mm-hmm. inquire about if they
That's
have any
great.
Situations or if they really would like to join. We're always looking for new quality members that want to give back to their community. It's all about our motto, We Serve.
Absolutely. We'll show you that towards the end of the program one more time. We're going to go to a station break for BCTV. Stay tuned. We'll be back in a moment.
You're watching The Victory Program on BCTV.org. Be informed. Be involved. Be a member. For membership information, go to www.bctv.org/support/membership. For more information and other related stories, go to www.bctv.org. The Victory Program is underwritten by Chandler Lodge 227 of the Freemasons and the Skyline Corvette Club. Program underwriting is a valuable source of revenue for BCTV.org and a way for you and your business to get exposure in the community. For more information on how you and your business can become program underwriters, go to www.bctv.org.
We're back with the Lions Club here in West Reading, Wyomissing. We're talking about Lions International. We really have some great information we're going to share throughout the rest of the program, in particular towards the end, so please stay tuned. Carl, if we could bounce back to you as past district governor, of your local club that you are host from is Morgantown Elverson?
The Elverson Morgantown Lions Club.
Tell us about how that club has grown over the years and the activities that you've accomplished within that club.
Well, we've been around since 1926, I believe, and we were sponsored by the Honeybrook Lions Club, and it has changed greatly over the years. It used to be an all-male club, but finally International smartened up. And in 1986, they encouraged women to join the Lions also. Because
absolutely. 51% of the population can really add to it.
That is correct.
And I'll tell you, that's an ideal way to do it, because when you participate in both diversities, you can get more active members.
Mm-hmm. Yep. They come up with wonderful ideas. Some of the things our club does, we have a night at the races. We have recently had a spaghetti dinner.
How did that go with the turnout?
That was great. You know, it's considered serving the public just by having something like that, and the funds will go to help maybe a child in school needs a pair of eyeglasses, and you would be amazed how many children are out there in elementary school who they think that blurry vision is normal, and when we realize there's a family in need, they will come to us, and privately we'll allow them to get glasses along with an exam, and it's that's just one of the many things we've also helped people who have low eyesight, but they need like a magnifying machine to help them do things like their banking or just reading a magazine, mm-hmm. and it's a big plus in their lives, and it just gives them all kinds of confidence in carrying on their own. We have also we've supplied a leader dog to a local girl.
Oh, and wow.
Lions International is very involved with Leader Dog out in Michigan. And if there's anyone out there who needs a leader dog, there's a process that you go through. And it's a two-week training for you out at Michigan. And usually your local Lions Club will pay for that plane ride. But it does not cost anything for to get the dog and everything. That's all covered under donations throughout the world with Lions. So that's just another thing we do, that any club can be involved with that.
That's great. Now, I understand there's almost 50 clubs within the district of 14P.
That's correct.
Now, 14P within Pennsylvania, is it considered medium to large size at state level?
We're on a larger side, even though we're just Berks and Chester County. I like to think we're the best. We do a lot of things in Berks and Chester County combined as districts. Yeah. Clubs get together for district functions. We have our district convention in Reading, as we did last year, mm-hmm. and it's just a great
event. Oh, yeah,
that
went very well. That was the state convention?
That was the state convention,
Let's put a little plug in for the Berks County Armed Forces Advisory Committee, where the Lions Club got together in association with that to put mm-hmm. on a fabulous, you know, Berks County Armed Forces Day Parade, which is the longest consecutive running parade in the U.S. Mm-hmm. It's going to be coming up for its 64th consecutive year this May. Always the third Saturday in May, so mark your calendars. Wanted to get that in. The Lions Club are back. They're helping out again this year mm-hmm. with the parade.
Mm-hmm. It's an honor for us to be a part of that. And we enjoyed very much at the wonderful parade.
That's what it's all about, giving back.
That's right.
And let's give another plug about all the money that is raised, again, by all these Lions Clubs. Where does that money go?
Well, generally, anything eye-related is what we're most important, our charity is. Going back a little bit, 1925, Helen Keller came to the Lions International Convention at Cedar Point, Ohio, and she asked the Lions to adopt her and to help her help others with sight-related situations as what she had. And since that speech, Lions International has done more for sight-related illnesses and situations than any other country or government in the world. That's how it all got started, with the sight-related situation.
Now, if we could go back to Dave and Charlie about, if there's a member out there that is watching the program and has a spark of an interest to become a Lion, what's the process they should go through? Naturally, contacting us through, as you saw, the website mm-hmm. and the email. But tell us about the kind of member you're looking for. Anybody that's willing to help out and volunteer?
Anyone who has a little time on their hands will come out, help the community out.
And the meetings you have are mostly a.m. and noon, and now you are offering evening meetings as
correct.
Well.
Yes, we're trying to make it as easy as possible to get people out.
Right, it's making it easier for the contact for the people to be part of it.
Yes.
And Charlie, what is the statute that they have to go through as far as dues? Is there a dues?
The annual dues for our club are $80. if a husband and a wife join, it's $80 for one and $40 for the other.
Okay.
So it's not a full dues if it's a family membership.
Correct. And there's many of those within West Reading Wyomissing.
That is correct.
Very good. What we want to do is get ready to show you the second segment on the Lions International to really give you more of an insight, truly, again, the good that is coming from Lions International.
Sir, could you step over here, please? Is there anything you want to tell me?
Like what?
Like maybe you're out to protect the environment?
Give scholarships to kids?
Fight blindness?
Help the elderly?
Feed the hungry?
Stuff like that.
Well, I only asked because you've got a little lion in you.
See? Right there.
Right next to whatever that other thing is.
Once its sights are set, nothing can stop the ferocious lion from capturing its prey. Relying on keen senses, lions search patiently before striking with alarming speed.
Wait for it.
Gotcha, Mr. Piece of Rubbish. He is truly the master of his environment. Do good. Be a lion. While lions are notorious for their voracious appetites, they spend a great deal of time feeding other creatures. In fact, lions will take great care to ensure there's plenty to go around. As you can see, they keep giving with utter ferocity. Bravo, lions, and bon appetit. Do good, be a lion. Did you know that lion's sense of vision is so powerful, it actually enables nearby creatures to see better? Here we see lions assisting the offspring of others, while their parents are elsewhere in the wild. Brilliant, isn't it? Making the wild kingdom look much better indeed. Do good, be a lion.
We're back with the Lions Club here in West Reading, Wyomissing. Our topic tonight is Lions International. Dave, tell us about, as sitting president, we have a December 15th meeting coming up, which is an evening meeting. Mm-hmm. Where will that meeting be held?
That'll be at Chef Allen's in West Reading, in the 500 block.
And the time is about 6:30-ish?
6:30, correct, yeah.
That night, you're going to be inducting some new members, is that correct?
Yeah, we're going to take that as kind of the end of the year, bring in and officially initiate any new members we may have to the club.
There you go. So if you're thinking about it and you want to come out that evening to Chef Allen's on December 15th around 6:30, you can learn more about what the West Reading Wyomissing Lions Club truly are all about. Meet the members, the officers, and better yet, become involved with your community through Lions International. Let's talk about other groups and clubs within our organization in the area as well. Carl, we were talking about that earlier this evening, how other clubs can interwork together.
Yeah, right now we have Lions clubs in the Pagoda Lions Club. They're an inner city club, which is looking to grow. Also, we have the Blandon Club. There's the, of course, our Elvis from Morgantown Lions Club, Exeter Lions Club, and there's numerous other ones that anyone can get involved in very easily if they were interested in helping the community.
Excellent. So if you see somebody out in your community that is wearing the great colors of the Lions, they have those vests on, or you see someone with a lapel pin, more importantly, ask, become a friend, become involved with Lions International. Charlie, as the treasurer of the West Reading Wyomissing Club, can people make donations if they so choose to bring to the club, even if they're not a member?
Yes, they can, along with the eyeglass collection. And I just became aware of this morning. One of the local clubs, actually two of them, have gone together to do this. They accept medical equipment for more or less recycling to people in need. And I mean, I learn more about Lions every time I talk about it, which is, you know, there's no end to the good and the work that Lions do.
It's amazing how it's all interconnected, as Carl was mentioning earlier tonight, how it all goes together. So we encourage you today to really get involved with your community. Become a Lions Club member. Go to the websites that you'll see at the end of tonight's program. I'm Tom Frank, thanking you all for staying tuned in to the Victory program here on BCTV.